awakening into the 144,000. Jennifer, I had found the following information very informative. What I am about to share is not my own, but I resonate to this as I have had many revelations of awakening as one of the 144,000. I am sharing this now because I find it to be critical at this time to the divine mission. This following information is written by an unknown source.
If you are fascinated with the subject of 144,000 souls, it's quite possible that you are one of them. Every day we learn that almost every single teaching left to us by the ancients, the ascended masters, the avatars, etc., have been manipulated by forces who know these teachings are powerful tools for us. It also includes the recent teachings by the spiritual New Age movement. This is why we always receive multiple stories about the same subject. The more we dig, the more confused we become. We get dizzy and cannot concentrate on which one resonates with our own being. I've always been fascinated by the history of 144,000 souls. I researched this topic for many years, and tried to obtain as much detail from many different sources. I will share with you a portion of my story. After reading the book, Prepare for the Landings by contactee Michael L. Jun, in May of 2011, I had an unstoppable desire, an urge to have a reading with him. Even before the reading, I knew that the Elohim were the creator gods. Also known as the Shiny Ones, the Chosen Ones. They answered a clarion call, and asked to be allowed by the Council and by Gaia herself to come to Earth to assist, to guide the planet and her inhabitants to ascend. Hence, they were chosen by the Council. My reading with Michael L. Jun was amazing. I was contacted by Ashtar and Lady Aphrodite. Within a few minutes, Ashtar told me that I was one of the 144,000 souls known as the original volunteers and Elohim, and I came to Earth about 8 million years ago. I was in absolute shock. Ashtar also said that as humanity wakes up, more volunteers will meet and have a soul family reunion, so they can work together to complete the mission, the pledge they made before coming to Earth. Because this is the last lifetime for them on Earth, most of the 144,000 are with their twin flames, so they are stronger, even if they are away from each other, and can fulfill their mission. When they meet, even for a short time, they are having an energy exchange which reactivates a new grid. Very often, it is done in a dream or astral state. Through research I learned that 144,000 is the number of souls that must attain Christhood, in example, ascend, and will reactivate the Christ light into the Christ grids to transmute Mother Earth and humankind. This is why Cobra is stressing the importance of having 144,000 people for the meditations and, or to sign up for the petition. It is the most crucial number of all for our liberation. Now, we will look at some information by others. Please go deep into your heart's mind and try to stay balanced. I'd like to start with a well-known passage from the Bible taken from the site.
Please see links in the description below this video.
Revelation 14:4 states that these 144,000 are first fruits to God and to the Lamb. If these 144,000 are God's first fruits, then no one else is included. The first fruits are exactly 144,000. Not one person less or one more. These numbers are consistent with the thousands and tens of thousands added together from the Old and New Testaments. As Christ says, many are called, but few chosen, Matthew 20:16. The bride of Christ is exactly 144,000. Revelation 21:2 describes the bride as the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God. At this point, she has risen to meet Jesus Christ, married him and is coming back to rule on the earth with him, Revelation 5:10. She will always be with him from this time on, I Thessalonians 4:17. This occurs at the last trumpet, 1 Corinthians 15, 50-52, the time of the resurrection of the dead in Christ along with those who are alive and remain. 1 Thessalonians 4:16-17. Revelation 21 describes the bride in verse 9, One of the seven angels talked with me, saying, Come, I will show you the bride, the Lamb's wife. The angel refers to her as the great city, the Holy Jerusalem, descending out of heaven from God, verse 10. Her wall is pierced by 12 gates, each a great pearl, the names of the 12 tribes of Israel inscribed on them and 12 angels at them, verses 12, 21. New Jerusalem is 12,000 furlongs in length, breadth, and height, verse 16. Her wall measures 144 cubits, verse 17. 12 tribes times 12,000 each is 144,000. 12 in the square of 12 is New Jerusalem's description. The bride is exactly 144,000, and the first fruits are exactly 144,000, Revelation 14:4. After reading, contemplating this passage and looking at these nonsense words from a different angel perspective, this is what I concluded. Now we know that the Christ's bride of gigantic proportions is his starship, the New Jerusalem, and not the city of Jerusalem on earth. So, what is hidden in these Revelations 7 and 14:4? Who are the 12 lost Israelite tribes? I had a true revelation and I saw the coded name of the 144,000, the first fruits of archangels and angels, as being the 12 lost tribes of Israel.
The following is an excerpt from the site, see links in description below this video.
The author is known as Little Worker. This seems to be a channeled message. Who are the 144,000 chosen? It was written by the mercy of God and announced by John the prophet that in the plenitude of the sixth seal, the chosen of the Lord would be marked. During the second era, there were 12 disciples who spread my doctrine throughout the world. In the third era, 12,000 of each tribe will be the ones to make my teaching of truth and love known to all mankind. 144,000 incarnated and discarnate spirits will open the way during this period. They will be forerunners, prophets, and messengers. The ones marked by me to go before the multitudes. Your presence before this manifestation has not been by chance. My voice summoned you along the pathways and guided you here. You have recognized the mission that you have to fulfill on earth. The 144,000 are the marked ones in this third era. Many have been chosen, but others along the journey of their own existence will be taken by surprise, and to them will be revealed, either by my divine spirit or through you, that they belong to the 144,000, and the sign that I shall give you that the number is complete, will cause a great commotion in your planet. Where are those 144,000? Elijah is reuniting them, some are in spirit and others are incarnated. All will be united spiritually in this divine work. The chosen 144,000 have to keep watch zealously over my law, to reanimate people in their journey. They will be warriors of peace, teachers within my wisdom, doctors for all illnesses, comforters and prophets. To extend my work in this third era, I will choose from among the great multitudes, 144,000 spirits, placing upon them a mark with a kiss of divine light, not a kiss of betrayal, nor a seal of some pact that places your spirit in danger. My mark is the sign that the Holy Spirit deposits in His chosen ones to fulfill a great mission in this third era. He who possesses this seal is not exempt from dangers, on the contrary, he is more tempted and more tested than the others are. The mark is the invisible sign through which his mission can be accomplished by the one who carries it with love, respect, zeal, and humility. Then he can confirm that the mark is a divine grace that makes him superior to pain, that illuminates him in the great trials, that reveals profound knowledge and makes a breach anywhere so that the spirit may pass through. The mark is a link that unites it with who possesses it, by which the thought and the word of the spiritual world can manifest itself in your world. So I say to you that a marked one is a messenger, an envoy, and is my instrument. Let's leave the Bible and move to more modern times. In November of 2012, at the Laguna Beach Conference, Cobra was asked who are the 144,000 souls. According to him, they are called the Order of the Stars.
See links in description below this video.
Third Atlantis, 16,000 years ago there was a task force called the Order of the Star. 144,000 beings and, or volunteers, came forth to heal separation and integrate the darkness into the light. They keep reincarnating wherever they can assist and are represented by figures such as Buddha, Christ, the Templars, and the Light Workers. When we liberate the planet, we will enter into the third Atlantis, a paradise on earth. We will create a new Atlantis with the cities of light and advanced technologies. The new Atlantis will arrive at the time of first contact. Order of the Star formed in Atlantis, they are here to transform all darkness and heal humanity. There are 144,000 beings. They are here to assist with the event and heal humanity. There will be a big need for healing after the event. The Galactic Federation has the Holy Grail. The location of the Holy Grail is undisclosed. This chalice was made of 144,000 facets of polished Moldavite. It activates the 144,000 light beings. Each facet contains a code for a star seed, and when the light hits the facet, the star seed is activated. The 144,000 is a complex mandala, and each person will have their own role. So, according to Ashtar and to Cobra, the 144,000 came to Earth about 8 million years ago. This is a comment by Starseed on Cobra's site. Syrian Starseed, June 5, 2012 at 1:58 p.m. The following is a true story about a dark period in the history of the planet. An ascended master named Sanat Kumara and 144,000 light-bearers. Long ago, around the time of cavemen, Sanat Kumara came to Earth to keep the flame of life, the threefold flame, for everyone on the planet. This was when the consciousness of the people had fallen to an all-time low, and no one honored God or the inner flame of the heart. A council of the cosmic hierarchy convened to discuss what could be done. Sanat Kumara convinced the council that he would keep the flame of the heart on behalf of the people until some did it for themselves. He was granted his request and prepared to go into exile when 144,000 light-bearers from Venus volunteered to support him in the mission. A special envoy went ahead to build the retreat of Shambhala on an island in the Gobi Sea. Today we know this area as the Gobi Desert. Sanat Kumara placed a focus of the inner flame on the altar where it remained in the physical for many centuries. Although Sanat Kumara resided in this retreat, he did not embody in the physical and remained in his higher body of light. What this master did was beautiful and demonstrated the love of an ascended master of light for all. He anchored a filigree ray of light from his heart to each heart on the planet and continuously nourished it, plus assisted everyone to be quickened by the consciousness of the Christ. After a period of time, people began to respond, and some of them started raising their consciousness and developing their inner flame. This allowed Sanat Kumara to return home to Venus. Many of the 144,000 light-bearers who were part of the original mandala are still here today. Some have returned home and others got sidetracked or entangled in karma. Today, we have the opportunity to pick up where we left off on the path of initiation with the Masters. To assist us, they have provided the teachings and the tools we need to successfully make the journey home. If you feel a tug in your memory, you might be one of them.
This is a quotation from a channeling by Susan Leland. See links in description below this video.
I am Sananda, one of seven Kumara brothers and sisters. The Kumaras are from a loving dimension of planet Venus. When the darkness was seen coming to planet Earth eons ago, we joined with our father Sanat Kumara, as part of a group of 144,000 Kumaras who came here to hold the light of love for the planet. We were present during the Age of Lemuria. Approximately 2,000 years ago in your time, I overlit the energy fields of one of the most famous messengers of love the world has ever seen, the one known as Master Jesus. Our mission was to seed peace upon Earth, along with the beginnings of your true golden age.
The following is an excerpt of a channeling by Karen Doonan. See links in description below this video.
There is much talk of the 144,000. And they are now awake and preparing for the roles that they are here to play. The 144,000 are in human form, but contain the genetics and codes that allow them to move into the new Earth, in order to prepare the ground for the dreaming that will take place, to move the human race into a new level of consciousness. This has been guided within your human history for eons. The distortions were put in place for you to believe that it would be some other race or some other way. They never left the Earth. They have walked amongst the human race waiting for this moment for eternity. Those who now heed the calling are moving into place, and those systems that will help them in their setting up of new ways of being, and of living are also being put in place.
Message from Elohim, Emergence of Christ Consciousness by Channel Tiara Kimara.
It's been confirmed by the Council of Elohim that we now have more than 144,000 people upon the earth, that are at least fifth level initiates and who are living in the frequency of Christ Consciousness. The 144,000 was the number needed to trigger the mass advancement of the race, including the great domino effect among all other planetary light servers, which now number in the several million across the globe. This 144,000 Christ harmonic is able to strengthen and raise the rest of us, and humanity, into direct experiences of Christ consciousness as we continue advancing in our remaining initiations. It is important to understand that our final initiations into Christ consciousness, initiations 4 and 5 cannot be taken until initiations 1 through 3 are completed, and there is unwavering mastery over the personality body, and our free will is completely surrendered. Again, this is for our own safety in the planetary acceleration, and also prevents any potential misuse of revealing power.
Credit to the author of that article, Jennifer.
Next is a revealing conversation with a dear soulmate of mine, Christine Preston, who is a messenger for the Great White Brotherhood. She wrote, 1,000 I am presences created 12 higher selves who then created 12 extensions, 6 plus 6 twin flames, and these are the mystical body of God on earth, the 144,000 saints who were not defiled as stated in the book of Revelation, and they are symbolically the true church that is not physical, but souls, the bride of Christ because we integrate Christ consciousness. So, with all this, I remembered my first etheric encounter with Ascended Master Jesus. Here is only one experience of a personal revelation I have had. This was a waking vision, or as I call an etheric travel, of Ascended Master Jesus, Yeshua, Immanuel, also known as Sananda. Back in August 2012 I found myself walking on a crystal bridge. It looked like a transparent rainbow flowing towards the way I was walking. In front of me, I saw a brilliant white glow with gold radiating from what it seemed to be like a dome. It did feel as if I was in a city of light. As I got closer, things became more refined. I could see structure and towers shaped without edges. I felt enclosed as if I was inside a place in space or dimension. I was very vivid and aware that I am here in this place. It felt so familiar. I've been here before. As soon as I thought that, I see a glow of another light source. I saw the outlines of bodies without faces. I then felt like honey was pouring over me. It was a very calm, loving presence. Directly in front of me, I saw a figure come out of that light walking towards me. As soon as I saw his face, I fell to the floor. I still get very emotional. Every time I tell this, I fight back my tears of joy. I was trembling as I saw his feet. He wore a white bright linen robe and a gold sash. He reached down his hand and said,
"Why must you fall in the presence of family? Come, take my hand and stand with me."
I then take his hand, which was glimmering as the stars themselves. I stood and noticed his stigmata. Still trembling, he pulls me closer to him and whispers in my right ear,
"I am Sananda. Welcome home, sister."
I awoke to this name I had never heard before. My first thought was, Google that name. I didn't spell it right the first time, but then pages of that name with pictures came up. I felt like I went into soul shock and I became flooded with that honey over me feeling. I knew it was his presence. That same presence that I dreamt in. I then realized it wasn't a dream at all. I was actually in space inside a ship. I kept searching. Then in my mind I saw a bird on fire and thought that was strange. I can't recall where I ended up, but I was looking at something called the Phoenix Journals. That light bulb went off in my head connecting the bird on fire to these journals. It was the second journal which caught my attention. The title, and they called his name Immanuel. I am Sananda. I read till I fell asleep. I awoke and I hear, read Revelations. It was my voice but not my thought. I had never in my life ever read the full expanse of the book of Revelation. It took me a few hours to read. Nothing stood out at me until I began Revelation 3:7, to the Church of Philadelphia. As I began reading, his presence came over me again. My heart began racing, my palms clammy, yet I kept on reading. As I was reading, my mind or heart was interpreting the meaning of the words being said. I got to the end of the Church of Philadelphia, put down the book and began to write. I was dedicating my church to Christ. Here is what I had written.
Written August 26, 2012.
I am thy church. I am thy key. My crown is placed upon my head. I am thy pillar in God's temple. I stand beside you, O Lord Sananda, in New Jerusalem. I am inside thy divine white fire, which I wear as thy robe. I thirst and hunger no longer, for I am filled with thy fruit and drank of thy living waters. Bright is thy sun which does not scorch me, yet radiates through my everlasting soul. In love I am with all that is. Inside this place is bliss and not a tear can exist. I have prepared thy way with your loving light, O Lord, so all will receive the glories of this new earth and new heaven. Hear now thy kingdom came. My brother of light, come upon this world and be with all brothers and sisters of God, so we sing of your presence upon us. I am holding fast to all I am and to you who holds the light of my crown. I stand as a pillar in your temple, O Lord, and I know I will not stray, for I may never leave the unconditional loving embrace of all that you are. Sananda, I know thy name, for Jerusalem is your kingdom that has settled within my heart. Through my heart thy heaven be. The dream of heaven we hold within. Give this to the world. He said.
This is why it's so very important to be unconditional love. To transmutate and elevate ourself to Christ consciousness, our holy fire within. I had came across Revelation 7 the next day. Another awakening moment for me of being one of the 144,000 who was sealed. I fell to tears as I asked Lord Sananda, is this what you wanted me to see? Why am I being shown this now? Why me? I did realize it then, but the answers would guide me to reveal that I am a chosen one. That I really am one of 144,000. After that day, nothing has ever been the same. I am now currently awakened into my I Am presence. The Christ consciousness within. My God, God is self. The true Church of Christ. The Bride. I now acknowledge and wholeheartedly accept my calling, my purpose, my mission, as I know I am one of 144,000. This includes my twin flame divine complement. I am here awakening others to their divine mission. The mission of humanity's ascension. I am now asking you who hears these words and feel that deep calling from within, are you one? I am blessed and honored to stand beside my fellow brothers and sisters of my tribe. Each of you know who is who, and in what frequency you reside. I am here. I am ready. Links to the verses in Revelation which spoke through my soul.
Please see the links below the video in the description.